The provisioning bridge provides a link between your on-premises LDAP applications and Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Through synchronization, account data created and updated directly on these applications is pulled into Oracle Identity Cloud Service and stored for the corresponding users and groups. As a result, any changes to these records will be transferred into Oracle Identity Cloud Service. So, if a user is created in one of your LDAP applications, then this change will be propagated into Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Let's suppose you're using an on-premises LDAP application, such as Oracle Internet Directory, as an authoritative source for your company's users and groups. This application lies within your company's firewall. As the provisioning bridge also sits inside of the firewall, it can communicate with both the application and Oracle Identity Cloud Service and serves as a link between them. Let's create a provisioning bridge. First, sign in to the Identity Cloud Service console with your administrative credentials. Expand the navigation drawer, click Settings, and then Provisioning Bridges, and Add. Enter a name and description for this provisioning bridge and save the changes. By default, this provisioning bridge is deactivated. The Details tab contains high-level information about the provisioning bridge, such as the name, description, Identity Cloud Service URL, Client ID, and Client Secret. The Identity Cloud Service URL contains the name for your Oracle Identity Cloud Service identity domain. The Client ID and Client Secret are used by the provisioning bridge to access Oracle Identity Cloud Service as an administrator. The Client Secret is encrypted for security purposes. To see the secret in clear text, click Show Secret. You'll need the Identity Cloud Service URL, Client ID, and Client Secret, so copy the values for these fields to a text editor. The Apps tab displays the applications to which the provisioning bridge will poll for changes to users and groups, and synchronize these changes into Oracle Identity Cloud Service. The Connectors tab displays the Identity Connector Framework connectors that the provisioning bridge uses to communicate between on-premises LDAP applications, such as Oracle Internet Directory, and Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Let's install the client for the provisioning bridge. First, download this client. In the Downloads page, download the Identity Cloud Service provisioning bridge. Verify that a success status appears for the download. Create a folder on the machine where you're installing the client, and then unzip the file that you downloaded. You'll see two files, startup.bat and startup.sh. The startup.bat file is used to install and start the provisioning bridge on a Windows machine. The startup.sh file is used to install and start the bridge on a Linux or Unix machine. For this example, you're installing the bridge on a Linux machine, so run the startup.sh install command. When prompted, enter a password for Oracle Wallet. The wallet is a secure file that's used to store sensitive information about Oracle Identity Cloud Service. When prompted, re-enter the password. At the Enter the Identity Cloud Service URL prompt, enter the correct URL. Then, enter the client ID that you copied earlier, and then the client secret. Skip the proxy server prompts, as an HTTP proxy server isn't required in this example. The bridge attempts to connect to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. If a connection can be established, then information about the provisioning bridge created appears. With the installation complete, let's start the client. At the prompt, run the startup.sh normal command, then enter the Oracle Wallet password. The provisioning bridge attempts to connect to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. The provisioning bridge is started status message verifies that a connection has been established between the provisioning bridge and Oracle Identity Cloud Service. On the provisioning bridges page of the Identity Cloud Service console, the status of the client for the bridge is now started. To confirm that the connector can be used by the provisioning bridge, click the Connectors tab. Verify that you see the names and versions of the connectors that are used by the provisioning bridge to communicate with the associated applications. Now let's activate the provisioning bridge by clicking Activate, and then OK. The status of the bridge is now active. With the provisioning bridge active, let's link it to an on-premises LDAP application, in this case, Oracle Internet Directory. Click Applications, Add, and then App Catalog. Locate the application template for Oracle Internet Directory by entering it in the search field. Click Add, and then click Next. Turn on the Enable Provisioning switch to configure synchronization between Oracle Internet Directory and Oracle Identity Cloud Service. grant consent by clicking OK. Select your provisioning bridge, and then enter connectivity information for the host name, port number, administrator username, administrator password, and base context fields with the values associated with Oracle Internet Directory. Then click Test Connectivity. The connection successful status signifies that a connection can be established to Oracle Internet Directory. Turn on the Enable Synchronization switch to synchronize between Oracle Internet Directory and Oracle Identity Cloud Service. In the When Exact Match is Found menu of the Configure Synchronization pane, set the value to Link and Confirm. This way, a link can be established for any users that are transferred into Oracle Identity Cloud Service from Oracle Internet Directory. With the Oracle Internet Directory application configuration complete, add it and then activate it so that it can be used to pull account data that's created and updated directly on Oracle Internet Directory into Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Now let's verify that the application you created and activated is associated with your provisioning bridge by navigating to it. On the Apps tab, the Oracle Internet Directory application is assigned to this provisioning bridge. With everything configured, let's use the bridge to pull a user account from Oracle Internet Directory into Oracle Identity Cloud Service. In this example, the Clarence Solana user account will be transferred from Oracle Internet Directory to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Notice this user doesn't exist in Oracle Identity Cloud Service, but does exist in Oracle Internet Directory. Let's import this user's account into Oracle Identity Cloud Service by navigating to Applications, Oracle Internet Directory, Import, and clicking Import. Click Refresh until the job status shows Succeeded. Notice that the user Clarence Saladner is now imported and visible in the Users page. Now you know how to use the provisioning bridge to synchronize users from your on-premises LDAP applications to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Learn more at cloud.oracle.com.